there's one thing I've learned over my career. We're all experts in paying our attention to non-important things. I know we're living in a world where certificates matter, and obviously they put a lot of pressure on those teachers who are just planning to tap into the world of ELT, English language teaching, teaching English as a foreign language. And they very often serve as a prerequisite for a perfect job you'd really want to land in your career. Many language centres require CELTA to be put on your CV to prove that you have the right qualification, so I can imagine how much pressure there is for a novice teacher to enter the world of ELT, which is highly competitive at the moment. And I completely relate to the sentiment. I acknowledge the fact that it's really, really competitive and you've got to find the right niche there. So there's just one story I'd really love to share with you, which I really hope exemplifies the point that I'm going to make later in this video. When I was starting out as a language teacher, I was really passionate about English. So while other children were playing football in the yard, I'd spent my whole evenings tapping into my English language skills and working on vocabulary, grammar, everything like that. Just browsing through units of a grammar book and everything like that, talking to myself in the balcony of my parents' flat. And I really enjoyed that time. So that would have to be my best years of my life because I was really, really passionate about English. I was so keen on learning it. And I do remember that when I just graduated, I had that feeling that I had to start teaching somehow because all of my teaching was based in my flat. So my parents very kindly allowed me to use their flat as a little office. So I'd invite people there and they would come and I would buy a little whiteboard, a flip chart, and I would teach using that flip chart and people seemed to enjoy it. But my parents told me, okay, so you do need a proper job, so why don't you go to a language centre or a university and try to apply for a job there? So I was doing that at the time when I didn't possess any certificates, so I haven't had any formal teacher training. All I have had was the time I spent in an English classroom with a professional English teacher, and I read a lot and I learned a lot about teaching, so I really wanted to do it. So I just did a few interviews where obviously I had to speak English, and even though I hadn't got any certificates at the time, employers were ready to give me the job because they really, really liked the attitude I had at that time. So I did a few interviews with the major linguistic centres here in Kyiv, Ukraine, and they were so happy to accept me. They said, oh yes, please, like, come and do the job for us because we really want to have you as a teacher. We'd love to see you on the team. And there was an employer who was looking for a master's degree in linguistics, but everything I had at the time was the bachelor's degree in linguistics. So I wasn't technically suitable for the job, but they were ready to give me the position and they said, okay, so just come and do it. I'm ready to put the fact that you've got the master's degree into the profile. So they were ready to lie, and I'm really, really thankful to them. I'm not suggesting they're just bad guys, you know, or anything like that. I was really happy they were ready to give me the job, but I just said no, because like when I came to the organization and I talked to the people there, and I think that companies are all about people, and I heard the English being just thrown at me at that time, and I thought, I really want to develop as a teacher. I don't just want to stay there. And even though they had so many CELTA qualified teachers on the team, the English level was not particularly good enough, to be honest. And I really wanted to continue working in an environment where my English could be constantly growing. So that's the reason why I chose to work freelance. But currently, I know the situation may have changed. There are so many other teachers out there who are passionate about English and about learning English and working on their fluency. So I don't think it is any longer the case, to be honest, but this is what I chose. And I've many times seen a thing such as dead certificates. A person gets a certificate once, so they pay for it, because CELTA is very expensive. It's fairly expensive for anyone working in ELT. So they pay for a certificate, they do it once, they do the trainings, they just, apply themselves to the seminars and everything. And that's it. So they receive the certificate, they put it into a little frame, they hang it on a wall, and that's it. So they don't do anything. They put the fact that they've got the CELTA certificate on their CV because it looks great on their CV, you can imagine, but they don't do anything apart from it. And that's it. So they get it and they stop it. Their development stops, it dies there. Although CELTA looks great on your CV, it doesn't make you a great teacher. You may have that knowledge, you may practice it a little bit, but if you don't do it constantly, if you don't do it on a daily basis, there's little chance you'll be able to become a good teacher. If you're a non-native English teacher, it's really important to work on your English fluency. And this is something I can't emphasise enough in my work when I train other teachers. I always tell them, work on your own English. Keep your English up to date. Stay tuned with the latest development in the world of English language teaching. This is really important. It's so valid. I do think we need to focus on that, because although CELTA gives you a qualification, it doesn't make you a great teacher. It's just a certificate, right? It's just a certificate. So if you just really want to rely on your CELTA and think, okay, so my CELTA will let me make my way in the world of ELT to the top of my career ladder, all right, you could do so. But your personal achievement is largely about paying your attention to important things and educating yourself all the time, no matter what you're doing, on a daily basis, tapping into podcasts you like, listening to the English you like, working in methodology, reading stuff in methodology, attending professional development webinars and attending the seminars run in your city. This is largely important. So in the comment section below, I'd really like you to tell me whether you've got any certificates and if they have made a difference in your career, right, as an English teacher. So this time I really want to focus on those of you who are teaching English practically in a classroom or on a one-to-one basis like I do. So that's going to be it for this video today. Thank you so much for watching it, guys. Thank you very much for leaving your suggestions for further videos in the comments down below. Please continue doing so, and I'll talk to you very, very soon. Bye.